In this video, I'm going to be showing you how to create this really cool wood and steel stair. This is really popular these days, however, Revit by default doesn't have the optionality and the tools to create something like this. However, there is a workaround, and I'm going to be showing you that in this video. We're actually going to be creating this as two different stair types, which we put together in order to create the final wood and steel stair. Let's go. Now quickly, before we jump into Revit, I would just like to ask you to check out my website, balkanarchitect.com. I'm going to link it up in the cards above and then also down in the description of this video. There you can find some ready-to-go Revit stair families that we have just released. It's a nice stair pack that has all of these unique stairs in Revit, so if you're interested in that, check it out. Also, there is a full course on stairs and railings in Revit, so you can check that out as well. Now, without any further ado, let's jump straight into Revit. And here we are in Revit, and the first step is going to be to go to our stair tool, open that up, and then here I'm just going to go with the basic 190 by 250 millimeter assembled stair. Now, before we continue, let's go here and do edit type. The first step is going to be to click on duplicate, and here we're going to call this wood tread stair and then click OK. Next, let's go to the run type and click, and then click on this little button here that's going to open up the type properties for that run. And we're going to duplicate this one as well, and let's call it the 50 millimeter tread. Click OK. And here you want to turn off the risers. The treads are going to stay at 50 millimeters. And then for the tread material, I'm going to search for some wood. So let's see. And let's see what we have here. So I'm actually going to use this birch wood. So let's load that in and click apply and OK. So now we have this set up. Click OK. Then you want to go to supports and you want to set both left and right supports to none. Hit apply. Okay, let's go to railings, and here for the railings, I'm just going to set this to none, so I don't want to see any railings at this time. And now let's place the stair by clicking once, extending, and then placing that stair. We can also check it out in the 3D view. This is what that looks like, and this is exactly what we want to see. Okay, so now let's model the supports that are going to be on each side. So for that, select the stair, go to level 1, and then let's go to copy, and I'm just going to copy this off to the side like that. Then let's hit the escape key a couple of times and select this stair. Now I'm going to go into edit type, and this being the support, I'm going to duplicate this, so let's call this 80 millimeter riser and tread stair. So let's click OK. Then I'm going to change the minimum run width to just 10 millimeters, just because this is going to be a support, so it doesn't have to be too wide. Then let's go to the run type and click here on edit, and then let's duplicate and rename it as well. So let's call this one again 80 millimeter riser and tread. Let's just change it to this. Click OK. And then here we want to turn on the riser as well. Now in this case, this will be set to 80 millimeters for the thickness of both the tread and the riser. And then for both materials, I want to go with iron. So let's click here, search for iron. Okay, so we have this one. Let's actually go with cast. Click apply. Okay, and now what you can do here is just click to select. It's going to highlight the text. You just go Control C to copy, Control V to paste, and it's pasted here, and we can just hit apply. Okay, and that should be it. So now I can again apply. Okay, and there we go. Next, you want to select this stair. You want to go into edit stairs, and now let's just change the width of the stair. So here I can just set this to 80 millimeters, for example. See what that looks like. Yeah, perfect. Go to move and then move it here. Go to the 3D view just to see what this looks like. And this is what we get. So as you can see, it looks really, really good. Now I also want to copy it to the other side. So let's go back here, go to copy, and then copy it from here to there. hit the escape key a couple of times, and there we go. Now, in some cases, you might want this part to attach to the top. In some cases, you might not. So you want to hover over it. It's going to say assembled stair. Then you hit the tab key once, and it's going to say run. And then you select that run, and then you can uncheck the ends with riser, and it can get rid of that one. So depending on how you want to construct this, you can have that checked on or checked off. I'm just going to leave it on for this demonstration. So there we go. That's how you can create this unique and interesting stair in Revit. Now, if you want to get access to all of my Revit project files, like this project file here, or any of my other ones, over 500 files so far, you can find all of that on my Patreon page, which I'm going to link up in the cards above, and then also down in the description of this video. Thank you for watching, guys. Make sure to check out my website, balkanarchitect.com, for more Revit courses. There I have over 120 hours of content, and I'm adding more each week. Make sure to subscribe for more videos, and also I've added a video over there that might interest you as well.